forgot what that is now. Anyway, how many times can we upgrade? No. How many times can we level up? I guess upgrade makes sense too, but anyway. I'll probably increase that twice, maybe. Put one into that. Maybe one into that. Yeah, cool. Why not? Maybe we'll kind of get Dex to 40 if we can. I always like to put one in VGR when it comes to leveling up. Just so my health gets a little bit more profound each and every time I upgrade. But anyway, yeah, it makes much more sense to... I don't like how the fact you can't just hold it and it stays like that anymore. It upsets me. But anyway, and I also don't like how the area around the spot you're targeting is all fuzzy and shit. But anyway, looks like you kind of crouch a little bit when you do that, yeah. Can't really... This looks a bit silly. Well, there's nothing wrong with moving it to the side like that. Or kind of having it horizontal, I should say. Anyway, so what we're going to do now is go to the final bonfire, which is Strayed Cell. This is going to give us quick access to Sinner's Rise, and of course we're going to get a bonfire pretty quickly once we get to Sinner's Rise, so... Yeah, I'm going to keep Pate Spear equipped here because I find it to be quite useful against those enemies. Pate Spear obviously gets more powerful the more we upgrade our dexterity, and is that halberd that I had, the blue halberd thing? Is that a proper dex scaling weapon? Like, oh, it's got a B scaling. This also has a B scaling. You prick. You little bastard. I like how I just have to... That is ridiculous. Okay. I'm just gonna, like, not talk here and do this because there's some noise outside. Alright, so that's taken care of. And there's still some noise outside, yay. Anyway, I'll just kill you quickly. And you as well, because you look like you're ready for a fight. I wonder if we can open this. If we can't, then... Yeah, okay. I was just wondering, because it did give us access to fall in here from another position. Thanks to the key we got in Belfry Luna. Whoa, hi. How about... Oh, didn't... I almost backstabbed him there, but it just didn't happen, unfortunately. Life gem times 8. Shit. I've been needing some life gems, actually, after that fucking boss, so I'm glad. Thank you for those free life gems that I don't have to spend souls to get. But I can just buy life gems normally from Melentia now, so that's always good. Yeah, be careful of them. They are annoying. Alrighty. Let's be nice and careful, because I believe coming up to this bonfire, things are a bit difficult. Sorry for the loud noise. I'm just having to, like, not talk so you don't have to hear the loud noise outside. It's really annoying. Anyway, yeah, this is why we need to be careful, because there are all these enemies around. Yeah, I'm really liking Pate's Spear right now. I mean, I said I didn't like it, but you know what? It's kind of cool. Anyway, just need to light the bonfire. And rest of the bonfire. Yay. The Salt Fort. Or the Salt Fort. I don't know what you want to call it. You can call it whatever you want. Anyway. Yeah, that's why I held up my shield there, by the way. In case you wanted to know. Wanted to hit your friend, too. And by friend, I mean this guy. I quite like this spear now. I'm sorry for speaking ill of you, Pate Spear, back when I first got you. Anyway, let's go and head off to Sinner's Rise. I mean, we are technically in Sinner's Rise right now, but this does... The enemy that we fight, by the way, is kind of like the Sinner, I guess you could say. I forget what he's actually named. Something like the Sinner. We need to pick this up, I think. Human Effigy. Okay. There is Sublime Bone Dust nearby. I remember checking to see, like, the locations of Sublime Bone Dust, and I remember there was one nearby to where I am now, so we just need to be kind of aware of that. I took a little bit of damage there, not really desirable, but oh well. You know how I play. Not very well. I don't play very well. That's how I play. Oh yeah, that's right. There was that fucking cage that I could have gone into ages ago. I wonder where that would have taken me. That would have taken me to pick up an item. How annoying. I forgot to go into that cage. Anyway, so we are now coming... Oh, that would be it right there. Let's go and get that. Someone we can summon. I'll keep that in mind. I think this is what we want. Oh, no, never mind. That's not good. We can't... What are we going to do now? We're stuck here, guys. Illusion ahead. You're bullshit. Are we seriously going to have to kill ourselves at this point? I'm not impressed. Shit! Well, how am I supposed to do that? That is the last time I fucking go there, ever. If I can't get my souls back, I'll be pretty unimpressed. Because ultimately, I mean, that's just really horrid. That's horrid shit. What I'll have to do is, like, when I go back down, I'll have to fall from it, and then I can fall. Yeah, okay. Not very nice. Not very nice. Oh, sorry, just stretching and shit. So let's go drop down here. Just make short work of this. I don't have the time or patience right now. Before you can... Wow, I'm quite amazed that even with the stone ring and this huge spear, I didn't even flinch you. Kind of bullshit, anyway. Like to kill you, thank you. Anyway. What are you doing? Having a nice day? Anyway. Yeah, we are doing quite a lot of damage with this spear now, since we have been upgrading our dexterity, which is great. Anyway. Of course, I'm going to be careful here, because... Yeah, I need to kind of drop to this thing. Okay, our soul is indeed there, so we need to be making sure we drop down there. We do have the cat ring as well, so we do have the ability to not take too much damage from falling. But even look at that. How ridiculous is that? Anyway, yeah, let's just fall there. So cool. That was just for some lacerating knives that weren't even that important. So this guy here, he's going to do a lot of damage to us if we're not careful, so we need to be careful. That's the idea. Loud as fuck birds outside. Do excuse them, those birds that are loud. So yeah, I don't want to go and step on the stupid elevator switch, so I'm just going to try and kill you. Fortunately, we can attack him from a bit of a distance, which helps. What the hell? Just falls right over. That is a lot of souls. That was like over 1,000, I think. Anyway, I think Sublime Bone Dust is right here. Yeah, it is. Okay, so we'll be able to upgrade the effectiveness of our... what do you call it? Bone flasks? What? Our Estus flasks soon. Would like to get you in a position where I can flinch you, but maybe not. Maybe that's asking a bit too much. Does help to be able to roll through this, yeah. And he's quite slow as well, which does help, most certainly. I'm out of stamina. Okay, let's kill you now. I like Pate's spear. Not the kind of thing I'd use for a boss, but you know what? Yeah. Killing these guys is actually really good for souls. I'll keep that in mind. Fuck. Anyway, there's another item here to pick up. And then there's like another one nearby, which we need to be kind of careful with, because it's kind of at a spot where you can die if you're not careful. I think I can hear your fucking chains, you little prick. Yeah, get out of my life. Okay, let's go fight you, seeing as though you're coming to say hi. let's drink. Come on. This is just an area that I think I'm going to go through kind of slowly at first, and then, like, when it comes to actually going to fight the boss of this area, I'll just go and run through it, because ultimately, like, you don't want to have, like, only one Estus Flask against the boss of this area, because he will probably do a lot of damage to you, even if you fight him well. So, yeah, just keep that in mind, because, yeah, it's just how that works. Let's kill you. You're going to drop something. I reckon he's going to drop something good. Malformed Skull. Don't know how that would be a weapon, but... Malformed Skull. Oh, that thing, that's right. Yeah, it doesn't have too much durability. That's the only problem with it. And we don't even have enough strength to use it. It's not too bad as a strength weapon. I have used it in the past, but it really doesn't last very long. That's the only problem with it, so... Yeah. Did Pate Spear have a... I thought it had a scaling with something else there. That must have been a different thing. Anyway, yeah, we're going to go this way. To where I was talking about, where we need to be kind of careful. It's just... Oh, no, not here. It's somewhere around here. There's like a like an entrance into some area, and we need to be kind of careful because we can fall if we're not careful. It's around here somewhere. Maybe it's a bit further down. That's weird. I must be totally misplaced or something. Anyway, okay. Maybe it's... wouldn't be around here, would it? No. I can see you, yes. Hello. So we need to kind of, like, look around in these areas, because you can't really see items under the water, so you need to kind of just wait. Just, like, go around the edges of these rooms and see if there are any items to pick up. I don't remember which rooms have items and which ones don't, so I can't make a quick process of it by just going, okay, no item in there, no item in there. You are horrible. You know how he did that? He was sitting underneath the water and then he came out. You little asshole. This is why, yeah, I'll probably just go back to the bonfire before I do anything. And I may even level up, that would be a good idea. Okay, no items in here. So people are putting messages in the water. It's probably not a bad idea. Need to be very careful, there's going to be one hiding around here somewhere. Oh, hi. I'm going to kill you before you can do anything. And then there's going to be one turning up around here somewhere, probably. Maybe not. Okay, we'll go pick this up then. While we can, Soul of a Proud Knight, Pharaoh's Lockstone. I didn't see how many Pharaoh's Lockstones we got there. I think generally you only get one when you ever pick one up, so yeah. Is that a... No, I thought that was a summon sign. I would have been very surprised. I'm pretty sure there's one hiding under the water here in this room. I've just got a feeling that tonight is not going to be a good night. Okay. Now, this time we'll go around to the top, and I will mention that if we do actually beat the Belfry Lunar area... I wasn't even intending to beat the Belfry Lunar area. I thought it was where Sinner's Rise was, but it actually wasn't. But anyway, okay, you're dead, yeah. Thanks for dying. Anyway, yeah, if we do beat the Belfry Lunar area, we can have, like, a quick, easy way to fight the boss. Well, not a quick, easy way, but, you know, it's kind of something to help us out, you know. What's this? Don't you dare. Don't I dare what? I don't get it. Anyway, let's just go roll over this side. Just looking for items in these jail cells, you see. I think... Jeez, what happened to the sound? You heard that. No sound happened. That was bizarre. That wasn't just you guys. That's for me, too. Very weird. Yeah, because we have the Bastille key, we can pick these things up. So this is great. Fire seed. Very useful if you are doing that. And by that, I mean doing that. Yeah, very specific, Doomlink. Anyway, yeah, if you are indeed... going through the game using the Pyromancy Flame, that will be useful to you. Anything here? No? Okay, so basically, what we can do with the Bastille Key is access something that will... Oh, that's right. I think that's something that is difficult for this area. If you do remember, in Dark Anor Londo in Dark Souls, yes. The problem with Dark Anor Londo was that you had a limited targeting distance. Now, the reason for that was because it was dark, and it was considered, okay, so it's dark here now, so what's going to happen is it's going to be like, oh, you can't really see, so you need to have the area light, otherwise you have limited targeting distance because you can't really physically see things. But funnily enough, if we light up that room, we're going to get normal targeting distance, because otherwise it just doesn't work. Now, how do we actually... I think, can we... Is it... there's something that we can use to actually create flame. Flame butterfly. I'm so glad that we have one of them. Let's go equip it. There's loud sounds outside again. I'm sorry for this. Sorry about that, guys. I'm back. I had to end up going and doing something. But anyway, let's go take on this boss. I'm not wasting any time. Let's just go. I've been waiting for so long to fight this stupid thing. Let's do it. Anyway. Yeah, we get the same old shit, you know the thing. Anyway, because this room is now lit up, we are going to be able to do a lot more than we would have previously. In the way that now we can actually target him from a decent distance, because you see how he jumps away there? That's really bad for us if we don't have this room lit, because it's not fun at all otherwise. Anyway, yeah, he is largely quite easy, so just need to roll. Oh, shut up. Great time for me to be interrupted.
I'm gonna kill myself.
Not in the mood. Not in the fucking mood right now. I just wanted to kill it. That's all I wanted to do. All I wanted. I didn't even want that much from that shit. Anyway, should I just run for it? I'll just make it quick. Boom, we'll be in there, we'll kill the boss. I probably would have killed him if I didn't get interrupted, but yeah, let's just go. I'm just gonna run there, and I'll see you guys there. I'll shut up, obviously. I just roll slightly too late every time. Oh, I can't handle that tracking. Thought I fucking used it. It did not respond to my fucking attack. Got one more. I can do this, I believe in myself. Come on, it's not responding. The tracking of that attack, it's too much. The tracking of that fucking attack. Ugh. Fuck off. Ugh. Anyway, great soul embraced. Yeah, I'm embracing it too. Fucking embracing the killing of that fucking asshole. Anyway, yeah. Look, that was another situation where I just had to get used to how to fight him again. I mean, you learn it and then you have to learn it again. Because it's been so long. Anyway, we are now to... Oh, you can't roll through these ones. And of course someone's using a circular saw outside, it's just, it never ends. Bonfire ahead. Let's open this. Ooh, fragrant branch of yore, that's what I was looking for. Alrighty. So, this is just a bonfire on its own, but it is a primal bonfire. So yeah, fuck. That circular saw. Okay, well, now I think we just automatically warp to Majula at that point. We're going to be able to level up quite a lot. I have to, like, keep on being silent for a period of time, because otherwise, like, the fucking circular saw just gets in the mic, it's really loud. Okay, we can level up quite a few times. Once again, one into whatever that is called, I keep forgetting. Get that to 40. Anyway, yeah, 40 I'm happy with there. Endurance, I want to get more endurance. Maybe I'll get that to 15, and, well, maybe we'll put that into strength, why not? Or maybe... We'll do that. Yeah, that's good. Soul level 85. We're getting up there pretty quick. So that's pretty cool. Now I believe we can actually buy that guy. Actually, we'll go and buy some life gems. Can we buy a never-ending amount of them? Wow. Well, that's pretty cool. Thank you, lady. So now that we have a fragrant branch of yore, we'll be able to go and access that area now, which is really great. That'll be the next location. But I believe this guy actually drops that armor set. Or not drops, allows us to buy. Okay, maybe not. Maybe not. I think we need to actually buy stuff from him to get him to a point where he'll sell different things. Well, anyway, it would be kind of nice to have that, to be honest. Maybe I'll just go and spend some money on him anyway. I reckon this is a better shield anyway, you know. I can't believe they don't do comparisons in this fucking game with armor and shit. Terrible. I'm sorry that I have to be silent so much. Anyway, yeah, so basically, at this point, I mean, oh yeah, you know what, I'll just let you guys fucking listen to that circular saw if you don't like the fact that I have to stop talking. Anyway, yeah, so basically, I just wanna, well, I will have to put some money into, I guess, you know, I might have been able to get more souls from actually killing that guy thanks to my silver serpent ring. But anyway, basically, I'm going to kind of stick with this shield now because it looks a bit nicer. But, yeah, I'm pretty happy with my current setup here at the moment. Like, in terms of my stats, it's all quite nice. I kind of do want to upgrade this weapon a little bit. It's proved to be quite useful to me, actually. But, yeah, I don't know. We'll go and equip Pate Spear for now. Because Pate Spear is always fun. Doing 268 damage. It's okay, it's got a lot of range, so... yeah, anyway. And it's got a rather effective running attack, too. So, that is nice. That kind of makes up for its lack of, I guess, strength, but... or power, I should say. Lack of attack strength. You know, but not strength stat. But, anyway... at this point, okay, you can do that for the special attack too. Anyway, I think I'm going to stop recording now, guys. I've honestly done enough. I think I've really done quite well this time around. I mean, yeah, I had a few issues fighting bosses, but I killed them in the end. That's where, I guess, skill can also be shown in Dark Souls. Your ability to constantly, like, keep on trying and not stop. You know, it's just... you can still work it out quite... you can work out... what? You can, what was I going to say? I was going to say something about... I don't know, that was weird. Like, I just forgot the phrase that I was going to say there, but, things will work out either way when you do that. As long as you continue to try, you'll eventually succeed, if I could speak English. Anyway, yeah, so that's about it. Next time around, what we're going to go and do is we will use a Fragrant Branch of Yule to go and access an area further over there. And, I'm not going to do it now because I do have to go and do some stuff, so... anyway, I may even upgrade the shield a little bit. In fact, I'll probably do it now off camera. But anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. This has been me, Doomlink. It's Dark Souls 2. Don't know what part it is, but it is the 5th of March 2016. Not March, May, you idiot. 5th of May 2016 as I'm recording. And let's just forget the S in this. How about that? Anyway, yeah. Of course, my commentary goes to shit at the end of the videos. As you know, this is not the first time this has happened. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. This has been me, Doomlink, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Dark Souls 2. Catch you later.